Best of five series. Hello again, everybody. Mike Lang on hand here, along with Terry Schiffauer. The Penguins find themselves down 1-0. The Islanders winning big last night over the Pens, 8-1, and a truly impressive performance for the Stanley Cup champions.
Well, we said last night the first few minutes would dictate the game. The Islanders got two goals in the first 6 minutes. Pittsburgh came back to get a goal on a power play to cut it to 2-1. But the key goal was Brian Trottier's goal in the final minute of the first period. That gave him a 3-1 lead. They poured it on in the second period, and it was no contest the rest of the way. The series, Pittsburgh has to win a game here if they want to go anywhere, because the Islanders have that extra home game advantage. Pittsburgh's got to get back in the series, and they have to get back in tonight. They can't rely on going back to Pittsburgh to make a comeback there.
No, the Islanders are just too strong a club, so they'll have to make a big stand tonight, I think, against the Islanders. We will see Billy Smith once again in goal for the Islanders, and Michel Dion will return for the Pens. Smith really was not tested too much last night. The Penguins will have to turn that around, too.
No, we said that if you can get Billy Smith involved to the point the way he played on Sunday in Pittsburgh, where he's out there worrying about people in his crease and hacking away at the ankles and slicing, that you might have a chance to get him a little bit off his game. But we never followed in on any shots. All the shots last night were long shots or dumping it into the corner. The 20-some shots, there was nothing really tested him. And the one goal by Boutette just came so quick that he never had a chance on it. Pittsburgh, on the other hand, tonight will make a couple lineup changes. Rookies Randy Boyd and Steve Gatzos, who played in Sunday's 7-2 win, they'll go into the lineup. Peter Lee and Ron Stackhouse will sit down.
The Penguins going into this game tonight will have seven rookies in the lineup and some new blood going for the Pens against the Bonnet Islanders. There's no question about that. How about the other series, Terry? All games going again tonight, game two of those series.
Well, a lot of surprises last night. Four of the teams that had home ice advantage lost last night. You had the Rangers losing at home, Minnesota losing at home, and, of course, Edmonton losing in a record-setting 10-8 loss to the L.A. Kings. I think L.A. went into their four corners offense once they got the lead.
All right, we invite you now to stay tuned. It's the Penguins against the New York Islanders, game two of this playoff series, and it's coming up right here on the Penguins Hockey Network.
Okay, kids, take a
break. Cook is it the most refreshing way to make the most of every day. And wherever you go and whatever you do, there's something big waiting for me and you. Cook is it the biggest taste you've ever found.
For your dining pleasure, Foodland has great prices on holiday favorites, like Agar semi-boneless.
The Penguins and the New York Islanders coming into game two.
For the Pittsburgh Penguins, Mario Faubert out with a broken leg, Jim Hamilton out with a broken hand, Greg Shepard bothered by knee problem, and not dressing tonight, Ron Stackhouse, Peter Lee, and Doug Shedden, Gary Risling, Bob Simpson, Dave Hannon, Tony Feltrin back in Pittsburgh working out. Nick Rickey was called into New York here today, but he will not dress for tonight's game. For the New York Islanders, they'll go with the exact same lineup as last night. Bob Nystrom and Hector Marini out with injuries, and Thomas Johnson scratched. They've added Greg Gilbert, the rookie who played in last night's game.
And played quite well, I might add, in a defensive role. Also had a couple of scoring chances. The announcers for this broadcast are contracted and paid for by the Pittsburgh Penguins. This copyrighted broadcast is authorized under the rights granted by the Penguins solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication or reproduction or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the expressed written consent of the Penguins is prohibited. And that's sent to you by our producer tonight, Brian Sipe. And Brian Sipe says you can pick up tickets to the Penguins game Saturday night against the Islanders. It's game three of the series at the Civic Arena box office from 12 noon until 8 p.m. And you can also call the Penguin Action Line at 765-3939 and charge tickets on your Visa or MasterCard. They are checking the nets. We had a repair job going on last night, and I can see John D'Amico down to our left going through the motions.
It's a big night for John D'Amico. He's working his 150th game as an official in the Stanley Cup playoffs and moves into third place on that all-time list. Quite an accomplishment. We asked him last night if they were going to stop the game and give him the net or if he'd be allowed to take home a piece of shoestring to commemorate tonight's occasion.
Well, the Penguins last year against the St. Louis Blues lost the opening game and came back to win the second and then split with the Blues over the next two at home at the Civic Arena, eventually losing game five in double overtime, the second overtime period. But they will have to be ready tonight. They have to come out a much stronger hockey club than they did last night against the Islanders. The Islanders, for all intents and purposes, really just toyed with the Penguins. They outshot them 19-5 in the first period and had things their way. The Penguins led by Michel Dion. Now look at the referee tonight. He'll be Andy Van Helleman, who has been bothered by back spasms. Andy has. He's worked the last couple of games of the regular season. He's going to give it a go. This is his first playoff game. And the Penguins coming on. Now the New York Islanders lost only 16 games in the regular season. The best club overall, points-wise, in the NHL. 2 years, I've won the Stanley Cup, and trying to make it an unprecedented 3 in a row for an American team. Trottier last night for the Islanders was absolutely phenomenal, along with Clark Gillies, who, according to reports here, had kind of a team meeting with his own squad after the game on Sunday against Pittsburgh, and kind of gave them the line in the locker room, a closed-door meeting of, hey, guys, follow me. We're going to do it again. And they kind of lined up behind him, and he certainly went out and proved himself.
I would think when Clark Gillies speaks, everybody listens and ready to move. He certainly made some fine hockey players out of the Sutter brothers, Brent coming up in mid-season, and Dwayne being here all year, and it just gives them a little bit more muscle. It just gives them that one added line, the line that can make the difference in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Now, we ask you all to please rise. Join along with Mr. Joe.
Did we mention the two linesmen working tonight? John D'Amico, we mentioned
D'Amico and Ron Foyt. Same as last night. Paul Flaherty, the standby official. Minor officials from Hartford. And now, our national anthem. To your left, Ron Foyt in the center, referee Andy Van Helleman, and at the bottom of your screen, linesman John D'Amico. Michel Dion, who during the regular season had a 3.79 goals against average, record tying 25 wins, 24 losses, and 12 ties, playing in his second Stanley Cup playoff game tonight. Billy Smith, a veteran of this, will be his 69th game with a record of 46 wins, 18 losses, holds the Stanley Cup record of 14 wins for the last 2 years for the New York Islanders.
Mike Bossy will not start at right wing. It'll be Brian Trottier at center with Tonelli and Keller on the right side. And for the Islanders defensively, Pont Vanamoral. Penguins control the draw, shoot it in. Baxter and Trottier collide at center, and I think we're going to get a penalty coming up here right off the bat. High-sticking call against Trottier. Trottier high-sticking the pins, foul ball Baxter, and off he goes. Trottier played a very tough last night. 5 seconds in.
You think Trottier and Malone get at it going right away. Malone puts it in. Trottier puts the stick up to defend himself. And a little more aggressive Pittsburgh Penguins to start the game tonight. Andy Van Helleman making the call. 5 seconds in. Brian Trottier, 2 minutes for high sticking.
Trottier's in. Gene Sismic of Butler, PA, will be our Foodland power play contestant. High sticking call against Trottier. Well, you've got to bump Trottier because he'll bump you all night long. Goring in a penalty-killing role with Carroll. The Islanders penalty-killing. The Finns scored last night. Here's Gardner with a shot, and Smith makes a save. Rebound, Kehoe, stopped by Smith. Oh, Smith made two key saves early. Boy, Kehoe has really had trouble here putting the puck on the net in the last 3 weeks of the season. And he had a golden chance there in the rebound. He's been making the plays from the passing department, but just hasn't been able to bury the puck and put it in, as Rick Kehoe can do.
Right off the draw, Gardner with a shot. Kehoe following up. Ends with two quick shots, 11 seconds into the game.
Citizens watch from Rogers. Dueler's on the line. Billy Carroll with the face-off has the puck, and he'll shoot it away off the boards. Back it goes behind the Penguin goal. Baxter sends it over to Randy Carlisle. And up on the left wing to Keogh. Back to Baxter, bounced off his leg. Carroll steps in, Goring steals. Shoot it weakly to the net. And Michel Dion of Pittsburgh sends it back behind the goal to Pat Boutet. Rolls it to Randy Carlisle. Minute 28 to go on the penalty to Brian Trottier. Carlisle looks for an opening. We'll go to Baxter on the left side. Back to Gardner. He's open. Here he comes. Going to take a shot. And the save is made by Smith. Three big saves by Smith early in the game. And the puck played away. Gardner, who led everybody in the NHL in power play goals this season with 21, has been turned aside twice by Billy Smith. Baxter rushes it up. Runs in the board. The Islanders have it. Keller to Dennis Potvin. Passing to Bourne off his stick, and it goes to the Islander bench. Well, the Pens certainly had good scoring chances. They had as many here in the first minute of play against the Islanders as they had the whole first period last night. And Billy Smith responding to the challenge. The Pens now with Mike Bullard, Steve Gatsos, and Rick McLeish. That'll be the power play unit up front. Minute 8 into the game, Price and Hotham will be the two-point man. The puck is played back into Pittsburgh territory. Price coming out with Bourne, approaching him. Price gave it away. Langevin had it outside the line, brought it in, and we have an offside call against the Islanders. Dave Langevin, who played well last night for the Islanders. There you see his stats on the TV side. Welcome to our simulcast this evening, wherever you may be. 48 seconds to go on the Islander penalty. And the Islanders steal the puck. Bourne's in. Give it to Adams. Going to put the power. That is off the moorings. Play will be stopped. Dion was bowled over. The Islanders on several occasions last night just went right to the net on top of Dion. People pushed him in. And the Islanders almost score a short-handed goal. They led the NHL in that department this year.
Pens careless in their own end. Islanders Bob Bourne walks in, tries to jam it right in. Had Goring on the right, tried to dish it off to him first. Bullard's pass, just not enough on it. Bourne gets to it first. Loses control, but the puck goes in, goes wide. And Price pushes Bourne in. They knock the net off the moorings. 40 seconds remaining on the penalty to Brian Trottier early in the first.
40 seconds left. Coach Eddie Johnson will make a change. Mike Bullard slams the door. And a little bit upset with himself that he made that pass. So it'll be Boutet against Butch Goring. Langevin moves in a little bit. Here's the cover Gardner. In the Penguins' end. Goring motions for Pearson to move over to the center point. Face-off won by the Penguins, however. And Baxter lays it ahead to Gardner. Scoreless game, first period. Penguins on the power play. Man advantage. Carlisle sends it away to the right wing corner. Off the boards, Billy Carroll. Can he get it out? A hit Baxter. Went by him. Look out. Goring's going to have a chance, but Dion will come out and get the puck before he can get there. Dion of Pittsburgh around that far side to Carlisle. Carlisle's pass to Keogh off his stick, and Boutet rambles back with 18 seconds to go on the Islander penalty. Boutet can't get into the Islander zone. Baxter and Goring collide, but the Islanders have the puck. Pearson skating to the Penguin line, turns around. Great penalty killing by the Islanders. And they shoot it up by. They were fourth in the league this year in penalty killing. Penalty is over to Trottier. Baxter ahead, and he rams Boutet. Is hit by Trottier. Play will continue. Back to the Penguins in. Here's Trottier in. Makes a move. Has the puck. It's going to be called back. Going to be called back. 17:44 to go here in period number one. No score. And this is the Penguins Hockey Network. All right. We've got a face-off at center ice. Singeron on with McClellan and Rod shut for the Penguins. And the Pens, Pat Price with a puck. Scoreless game, shot into the Islanders in. Billy Smith will travel behind the net. McEwen takes over, and McClellan bumps him. It comes to the near wing. Here's Gillies, lost it, now McClellan. Gillies will get it, trying to pass it out, can't do it. Singeron looked ahead for McClellan. He's knocked down by Gillies. Play will go on, and Gordy Lane of New York sends it around the right wing. Penguins keep it in. Shot by Boyd. Oh, a good one, and a good save by Smith. Oh, Randy Boyd really cranked up a hard shot from the left point.
I think Andy Van Helleman might have overlooked the hooking call there on Clark Gillies. But at the other end, right before that, when Brian Trottier came out, Pat Boutet was guilty of a slice. So he's trying to let things go a little bit and still maintain control.
Penguins changing lines very very frequently here in this first period.
Out of town, Buffalo and Boston are tied 1-1. Middleton for the Bruins. Dale McCourt for Buffalo. Edwards and Moffitt in goal for the two teams.
Mike Bullard with Rick McLeish and George Ferguson against Trottier's line. The Penguins control the draw. Carlisle left point, a shot, and it hit something and went up into the crowd again. The Islanders out here with Trottier, Brent Sutter, and Clark Gillies. A new look here for Al Arbor. Dennis Potvin and Kenny Morrow back. Scoreless, 2 minutes and 47 seconds into the first period. Well, the Islanders love to jump on you very early, get that first goal, especially here at home. They're awfully tough to beat. Now Gillies will come off to Nelion, and Bossy will work the right wing. Penguins control the faceoff. Here's Baxter coming up to the Islanders. And shoot it away to the left wing corner. Morrow goes back to handle the puck for the Islanders. Try to get it out. He does to Trottier. Trottier looks for Tonelli. Shoots it away to the Penguins in. Off the corner boards. And Dion read that perfectly. Ferguson behind the net. Tonelli checking ferociously. He goes down. Ferguson battling. In that far corner, Trottier knocks down Ferguson. Right point. Bossy has the puck. Bossy moves in. His shot. And a stop by Dion. He came through traffic and let that one go. Lower to Pittsburgh. And the Penguin center iceman will lead the pins in scoring, coming to center. Now to the Islander line. Long shot on Smith, and he got a stick on that. Left wing side, McLeish couldn't handle the puck. Can he keep it in? Can't do it as Morrow plays it back to center. Randy Boyd, Penguin rookie defenseman, whip it into the New York zone. Smith will drop it in behind for Dennis Potvin. Penguins go to another quick change here. Malone, Gatsos, McLeish still on. Tonelli and Boyd collide at center. Loose puck along the far boards. Now they jam it up, and Van Elleman says, let's take a faceoff.
Attention, please.
Penguins playing much better in the first period here than they did last night against the Islanders.
8-6, ALP.
And they've had some chances to score here against Billy Smith. Now we'll see Goring out here with Bobby Bourne moving to the right wing, and Greg Gilbert, the rookie, on the left side. Gatsos, a rookie on the right wing, Malone and Boutet. And the puck is played into Islander territory. Gatso sends it away around the net. Pearson after Malone, trying to take it away. Ties up Pearson. Boutet's able to get the puck. Boutet of the Penguins behind the net to Malone. Malone pinned to the boards by Pearson neatly. Gatsos goes behind the cage. Longevich in there trying to get it free. Gatsos works to the left wing corner. Gatsos kicks at the puck. Nice skating by Gatsos. He goes to Boutet. Boutet, center back for Gatsos. Deflected, and it goes through to center. Randy Boyd to Pittsburgh going with the puck to Price, up to center to Malone, right wing to Gatsos. He can fire the puck. He puts it back in the slot, and the Islanders come up with it. Longevin taking Gatsos down in the Islanders' zone. Puck comes back around the net. Bobby Bourne of New York, who can fly like the wind. Coming up, Price makes a nice move, gives it to Malone. His shot, and Smith caught that with a glove. Penguins putting good pressure on here. They'll have to continue it. Bobby Bourne at his own line, drops it back to Pearson. And Stephan Pearson, relay the puck to Longevin. Up ahead of Goring, outside call. Offside, the call against the New York Islanders. 15-11 left here.
Strong first 5 minutes for the Pens tonight compared to last night's effort. Some good checking. Starting to use the body tonight. Eddie Johnson said last night looked like a no-hitter. He couldn't recall anybody that handed out a good hit on his side.
Brent Sutter with Gillies and Dwayne Sutter. Against Singeron. Singeron comes up with the puck, and he'll snap it into the Islanders' zone. Right behind the net, Billy Smith. Wants Gordy Lane to handle the puck. He'll go to the near side. Gillies is checked by McClellan. Play goes on. Singeron, a shot. A good save by Smith. Singeron after the puck again. In the slot for Rod Shutt. It went too far for him. Shutt is knocked down. Here come the Islanders. Out to center. Right side. Dwayne Sutter. Slap shot. Dion stopped him. And he holds on. Singeron and Dwayne Sutter bump each other a little bit. Boy, the Penguins here with some good close-range shots on goaltender Billy Smith. And so far, he's held them off.
Probably had more good scoring chances tonight through the first 5.5 minutes than they had during the entire game last night.
Brent Sutter, the rookie, stares in at Singeron. Singeron finished the regular season with 10 goals. Puck play to the near side of the Penguins end. After it, McEwen. Whip it to the near corner. Gillies goes after it. He had 2 goals, 2 assists last night. Right side to Gordy Lay. Whip it towards and that Carlisle knocks it down with a glove. He takes a heavy check from Brent Sutter. Good check by Sutter. Here is Rod Shutt skating back. Out to Baxter. To the Islander blue line. Cuts around McEwen. Goes down deep. Nice play. Goes to McClellan. Drop pass in front of Carlisle. Oh, his shot is blocked by Gordy Lay. Oh, my. How he never got shut up, I'll never know. Penguins still checking the Islanders. They'll take it away. Bullard lost it, though, at center. Carlisle goes back. Penguins with a pretty play. Sutter and Paul Baxter stick each other. Here's the play back. Bullard was knocked down. Andy Van Hellemann was not watching that play. Watching up ice instead of Baxter and Sutter. Here's McEwen back into the pins in a shot. Oh, right of the arm. He had him beaten on the play. But Big Ben struck one. Great action so far. McLeish trying to get to the puck. Can't do it. Ferguson will take over. And the Berkey Flyer looks ahead for McLeish. Off his stick, trying to poke it up ahead. Unable to do so. The Islanders relay it to Keller. And he drives it to the right wing corner. Penguin zone. McLeish goes after it. On the backhand. Pass it out right to Tonelli. Tonelli comes in. Drop pass. Penguin steal. Here they come. 3-on-2. Boyd, Ferguson, Bullard. Back in the play is Keller. Good effort by Keller. Ferguson's shot knocked aside by Smith to the crowd. 13:26 left, first period. We are scoreless here in game two, and this is the Penguins Hockey Network. Face off in the New York zone. George Ferguson went off the ice. I think he might have aggravated that groin injury he's been having a little bit. He kind of winced a little bit as he sat down on the bench. Here's Potvin behind the Islander goal. Penguins have controlled the play here in the first 6 minutes of action. They've had the better of the shots, but they have nothing to show for it at the moment. The Islanders have the puck at center. Keller, shooter to the left wing side. Into the Penguins in, and Carlisle back to handle the puck. Icing called against New York. And they bring it back the other way. Well, the Pens have to get Rick Kehoe here going in this playoff series. He has only two lifetime goals in the playoffs, and he just has to score. He's one of their better guns, and the Pens out here now with Malone and Boutette, the other members of this line. The Islanders with Trottier to go against Malone. And the Islanders control. Dennis Potvin. Potvin on the year had 9 goals that he had. First goals of the game. Very important goals. And the puck is played up into the crowd again. The record will show that, especially for the Penguins, that first goal is so important. We told you last night during the regular season when they scored first, they were 26-9-9. When they did not, they were only 5-27-4. Eddie Johnston, Penguins head coach. And to the right of him, left of your screen, John Doolin, the Penguins equipment manager. And the Islanders force it up to the Penguins end. Pat Price in front of the net. Swings to the left, out to center, now to Sengaron. Sengaron trying to beat a man, does. Gilbert comes to the Islander zone, lets a wrist shot go. Knocked down by Billy Smith, who was partially screened. Around the near side, Price takes Gilbert into the board. Boyd trying to keep it in. He did not. He was outside the line. He let that quick little wrist shot go, and Smith went down. 12 minutes and 38 seconds left. Sengaron. Acquired from the Los Angeles Kings on waivers. Late in the season. The rookie McCullen on the right side and Rod Shutt on the left. Goring now with Gilbert and Bourne. Battles for the puck and the penalty coming up here. Penalty coming up against the Penguins. Single run. Islanders, I think, will get a power play. We'll take a break. 12:33 left, first period. No score, and this is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Aron gets 2 minutes for hooking at 7:27. First penalty against Pittsburgh. Last night, the Islanders went 1-for-5 on the power play. See Saint-Laurent pull down Butch Goring with the hook. Pens will be shorthanded for the first time in the game.
The Islanders and Penguins in game two. The Islanders lead the series 1-0. And they'll get their first power play crack. Boutette, though, into the Islanders' end. Shorthanded. Comes down. Takes the shot. And Smith went down with that butterfly style and made the save. Now Tonelli of New York picks it up. He'll pass it out to Mike Fossey. 64 goals in the regular season. Had one last night. Into the Penguins zone, right wing corner. Tonelli leaves it behind the net. Carlisle clears it away from Trottier. Near boards. Pearson in front. The Bossy is shot. Hit the post to the right of the yard. Pearson handles it again. Pearson, they're trying to clear Tonelli. Now Bossy has it. His shot. He scores. The Islanders get the first goal. Mike Bossy blasting the puck.
Bossy saw limited action last night, only playing on the power play. He's out there again tonight on the power play. Tonelli does a lot of hard work in front, serving as a screen. Carlisle can't get him away. Dion doesn't really have good sight on the puck. Bossy with the shot, stayed low, Islanders break on top, 1-0, a goal at 7:57.
Second of the playoffs for number 22, Mike Ottinger.
Right between the legs of Michelle Dion.
Number 7, Stefan Pearson. And number 19, Brian Trottier.
Pearson and Trottier. Trottier continues his streak. Now 27 consecutive games with a point.
The Islanders take advantage of the penalty to Cingarron, and they cash in. And the Stanley Cup winners will. Into the near corner. Penguin zone. And Gatsos turns around. One of the Islanders knocks him down. It's Wayne Merrick. We'll have a face-off in the Penguins' end. Well, here are the Penguins battling hard, getting the better of the play in the first period. The Islanders get their first chance in the power play, and bingo, it's in the net. What, Bossy really thread the needle on that shot. He's got great power behind that.
That's Bossy's 38th goal all time in the 37th all time. Moves him ahead of Dennis Potvin for the leadership in that category for the Islanders.
Merrick with Dwayne Sutter and Clark Gillies on for New York. They are back to equal strength now. Bullard with Gatsos and McLeish. Here's Boyd up the left side to Rick McLeish. McLeish at center. Throw it up to the right wing corner, Islanders zone. After it will be McEwen. McEwen behind the net. McEwen, pass it Lear side to Clark Gillies. Can't get it out. Bullard gave it right back to McEwen. And McEwen rushes up. He's got a full head of steam. Let the shot go. And the save is made. Rebound. McEwen got his own rebound. It went off somebody up into the crowd. Well, McEwen just took it off with a great burst of speed that time for the Islanders.
Islanders do a great job of taking that initial shot and just following it right in. There's McEwen going in. Gillies, Merrick, three players going in after the rebound.
McEwen, of course, started his career with the New York Rangers. Billy Carroll on for the New York Islanders. He'll have Tinelli and Brent Sutter, and so Al Arbor's really moving his troops around. Left side, McEwen, a shot. That hit McClellan of Pittsburgh, and down he went. Here's Rod Shutt back for the Penguins. Shutt to the Islander line. A shot is blocked by Lane, and McClellan is hurt. Now the Islanders move it again to the neutral zone. Tinelli takes a lead pass. Stopped by Carlisle. Rod Shutt to Rick Kehoe. McClellan comes off. He was hit on a heavy shot off his ankle. Kehoe with the puck, passing to Cingarron. Cingarron trying to beat Carroll. He does come to the Islander zone. Zigzags in. And trying to leave it at the left point for Carlisle. Penalty coming up. It's going to be against the Penguins. Penn's guilty of a high sticking call. And we have 10:35 left in the period. The score, the Islanders 1, Pittsburgh nothing. This is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Sticking at 9:25. Second time in the period that the Pens have been short. Islanders capitalized with a power play goal by Mike Bossy. And Bossy and Trache are right back out there ready to go. 10:35 remaining first period.
Well, Boutet and Ferguson will try and kill it. Potvin right point. Left side to Pearson. Will he shoot it? He holds the puck a long time. Skates it over. Passing to Potvin. Back to Pearson. To Bossy. Look out here. He loves that short side. Goes in front. And Boutet breaks up the play. Islanders maybe with one too many passes that time. They still have the puck in the Penguins' end, however. Carlisle trying to work it free. Comes to Trottier. To Potvin. Slap shot. Safe made. Fighting on rebound. It's loose in front. Bossy plays it out. By Potvin, it goes back to center. Boy, they are jamming Dion on that net. First two games of this series. They're throwing people at him. Trottier, right side. Coming down. Knocked down by Carlisle. Off the near boards. Baxter trying to move it out. And get it to Ferguson. And the Islanders recapture it. Going back to their own end of the ring. Potvin with a minute 10 to go on the penalty to Pittsburgh. 1-0 game. Passes up the left wing. Trottier avoids a check by Baxter. Keeps coming, but he couldn't get the puck. Dion spins it around. Far side. Gillies steals. Gillies back to the right point to Potvin. Penguins trying to shut it down here. To Gillies. Backdoor pass to Trottier to the left of Dion. He's by himself. Pass it to Gillies. Cutting across the slot. Couldn't get to it. Pearson will. To Potvin. Center point. Power play for the Islanders. Right side to Trottier. Boy, they are working tough. Trottier slap shot. It went by Gillies' stick. On the left side, Pearson. Gillies is so tough to move from that net. Here's Boutet clearing the puck up ice. 33 seconds to go on the penalty to Cingarron. Step on Pearson. Gives it to Captain Dennis Potvin. Pearson, the bucket at Sutter had it. Leaves it for Pearson again. Boutet moves in on him, trying to stop him. It comes to Gillies, left wing board. The punt man, center point. Wrist shot, stopped by Dion. Rebound, Gillies, he's got a block. Gillies had some net that time. Punt man, can he keep it in? Oh, great play there. Far side to Gillies. Slap shot, a good save by Dion. And the Islanders all over the pins right now. Sutter to Gillies. Off void stick, it goes over the glass of the crowd. Penguins have killed it. Great effort by the Islanders, but the Penguins come up with the job, killing the penalty.
Michelle Dion with some big saves. Clark Gillies just set up camp right in front of the net. Pens couldn't move him out. There's Gillies with a shot. Dion doing a good job standing up, making the save. Pens kill the penalty. 8:35 remaining, first period.
McClellan is back on for the Penguins. Shot on the left wing, Segarand at center against Goring, Gilbert, and Bobby Bourne. Boyd and Price working defensively. And the Islanders shoot it to the Penguins end. Pat Price will stop it in front of the net. Trying to skate it out. Gilbert coming after him, has nowhere to go. He got it through finally to Schutt. Rod Schutt hit by Morrow, who got the stick up into him. And it will be Butch Goring, Islander center iceman, to Gordy Lane. Check by McClellan. Scoots away from the check. And sends it slowly to the Penguins' right wing corner. Rod Schutt is back. He's knocked down. He lost his balance. Goring was coming in. I think Rod just lost his balance off his skates, lost the edge, and went down. We get a face off to the left of goaltender Michel Dion. The Islanders in preliminary round games, which of course this series is, are 13-2. And they're very tough. New York goal by Mike Bossy at 7:57 of the period. Draw. Goring. McClellan moved in. He fell down. Bourne left side to Lane. And his shot never got to the net. Goring trying to pass it back in that slot area. Cannot do it. Schutt plays it off the boards. It goes through to the center red line. Gordy Lane. Islander defenseman again with the puck. Penguins trying to make a change. Comes ahead to Bourne. Trying to beat Carlisle. Comes around Baxter. Knocked down. Carlisle on penalty. Hooking call against Randy Carlisle. And the Penguins are digging themselves a hole here. We'll take a break. The score, the Islanders won. Pittsburgh nothing. This is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Pittsburgh penalty number 25.
The last 5 minutes, the Pens will be shorthanded. Randy Carlisle goes off for hooking at 12:13. Third power play chance of the game for the New York Islanders. Carlisle with the stick into Bob Bourne. The Pens will be short.
Boutet and Trottier. Trottier won the draw. Right back to Potvin. Wrist shot towards the net. Loose in front. Trottier's shot stopped by Dion. And played away by Ferguson. And it goes the length of the ice. Back to Islander territory. Dennis Potvin. With control of the puck. Moves slowly to the right of his own goal. And leads a four-man rush to center. Left side to Trottier. Into the Penguins' end. Ferguson can't stop it. Trottier sends it around. Open space. Right point. Potvin. Left side. Good pass to Pearson. Pass to Bossy. Try to get it through the legs of Price. Couldn't do it. Pearson, right side to Potvin. The Islanders passing magnificent. Tinelli with the puck. Cranks it up. A shot. Hit the on. Hit the side of the net. Tinelli gets it back. Tinelli behind the cage to Trottier. Out to the right point to Potvin. His shot. Stopped by Dion again. Islanders are a pleasure to watch when they pass the puck. Cleared away by Ferguson and away it goes. Precision passing by New York. They lead 1-0 here. 6:48 to go in the period. A minute to go in the penalty to Carlisle now. Trottier on the move. Has a half a step on Boyd. Put it in front to Gillies. Nope, it didn't go that way. It went behind the net. Gillies near corner with it. Trying to find an open man. Price in there against three Islanders. Bossy to Trottier. Poked out by Price. Price doing a good job working there. Bossy works it free to the left point to Pearson. Over to Bossy. Look out. His shot blocked by the Pens. Pat Price. Price doing quite a job here killing this penalty. Here's Segarand. Into Islanders ice. Cuts down the right side. He moves towards the net. Taken out of the play. The Islanders punt man. 25 seconds left in the penalty to Carlisle. Sends it out to Dwayne Sutter. Penguin saw it. Brutal to net it went. Dion stopped that. The Islanders now have had a lot of shots here recently. Behind the net. Dwayne Sutter. Brent's in front. Gillies two. Goes instead left point to McEwen. McEwen, right side, Potvin. Back to Sutter. Dwayne Sutter shot. Baxter blocked out. And up to the Coliseum crowd it goes.
Islanders are not only sending one man in front to distract Dion, two players have been in their camp. A little while ago, it was Gillies and Trache, and in this last rush, Trent Sutter and Clark Gillies.
Well, Rick McLeish will be joined by Mike Bullard now. Or is Bullard going to come off? Yes, he will. Ferguson just giving me the impression that he is in some pain out there for the fans. Just not quite the full strength. Now Baxter and Chorney, the two defensemen on for Pittsburgh. 5 seconds left on the Carlisle penalty. The faceoff now, so very important here. Penguins shorthanded. You don't want to give that puck to the big man, Potvin, about his fire. And McLeish stepped in. Keeps the puck there in the circle. Good play by McLeish. It comes through to McEwen, though, center point. Shot blocked by Ferguson. Carlisle's on. The penalty is over. There is Ferguson to center. He'll blast it to the Islanders. In and offside calls. McLeish was into the Islanders zone ahead of the play. 5 minutes and 39 seconds to go. There's a look at Ferguson, and he just is not 100%.
Still very well remembered for the overtime winner against Buffalo in 1979. Out of town, Quebec leads Montreal 1-0 on a goal by Pat Hickey.
This one's 1-0 New York. First period, Mike Bossy, the goal-getter, on a power play. Islanders have the disc, and they shoot it up to center. Goes through to the Penguins' end. Gorey's coming after. Dion has to play the puck. And the Penguins will skate it up. Baxter, cut around Bourne. Four-man rush to the Islander line. Baxter is in. Drop pass to Bullard. Can he get there? He does. Nice play around. Goring a shot, and that missed the net. Ferguson of the Pens. Trying to put it out in front. It comes to McLeish. He can't shoot it. To the left wing corner. McLeish of the Penguins is after it. Throw it around to Bullard. Langevin pins him against the wood. Ferguson comes in. Billy Smith yelling to freeze the puck. And that is what happens. Billy Smith shouting instructions to his teammates. And a look at Mike Bullard, who is still looking for his first goal in this playoff series. Mike, of course, led the way for the Penguins last year against St. Louis. First two games. Of course, it's early here in the second game. He just hasn't been able to really get himself on track at all.
Game three. Go ahead. Game three of this series, Saturday night, back at the Civic Arena. Game time at 8 p.m. And if the fourth game necessary, it'll be Sunday at the Civic Arena. Face off at 7:35.
Penguins suffered their worst loss in playoff history last night against the Islanders, 8-1. Trying to bounce back here. Trottier with Billy Carroll now on the left wing. Of course, they'll make a change here. Trottier won the draw, and that's why he was on. He did that so many times last night. The Islanders bring it up out of their own end. Trottier will go to the bench. Here comes Morrow into the Penguins' end. A wrist shot, missed the goal. Over to the Penguins with the puck, passing to Ferguson. And Ferguson just dumps it back to the neutral zone. Gordy Lane, bearded defenseman, flip it away to the Penguins' right wing corner. Dwayne Sutter, nice play to center. Baxter had it. Now Mary Gossie shoots and scores. Wayne Murray gets the second of the playoffs.
Dwayne Sutter goes in, knocks it down in front. Baxter has it, loses control of it. Merrick with the shot just inside the post. The Islanders go on top 2-0. Merrick from Wayne Sutter.
The assist to number 12, Wayne Sutter. And number 24, Gord Lane.
Gordy Lane also picks up an assist on the goal.
25. Merrick from Wayne Sutter.
So the New York Islanders now have a 2-0 lead. Randy Boyd left side, a shot blocked. Here's a breakaway chance by Dwayne Sutter. Moves on Dion. His shot missed the goal. Sutter turned around by Pat Price. Billy Carroll trying to put it out in front. Boyd takes it away. Boyd moves it up to Greg Malone. Keogh's open on the right wing. Can he get it to him? Keogh takes it to the Islanders' end. Off his skates, an offside call against the Penguins. And we will take a pause right now. Timeout. 4:05 to go. First period, the New York Islanders 2. And the Penguins nothing. This is the Penguins Hockey Network. Penguins down 2-0. They're starting to get into that same mold as last night's game. And against the Islanders, you cannot play like that. You will not beat this club. You don't have enough talent, the Pens don't, to compete on them on a goal-scoring basis. You've got to hit them and slow them down. The Islanders are freewheeling now. Here comes Tonelli. Out the left side to Brian Trottier. Up on the right wing to Tonelli. He's around a man coming down towards the net. Baxter breaks it up. Trottier centers. Keller has a turning shot and a save by Dion. Right wing corner, Keller. Hit by Singerot, and Tonelli takes over. Benz can't get it out. Here's Trottier again. Slide it over to the near corner. Keller played around the net. Keller again to Tonelli. Tonelli throws it out. Mott Schutt takes it. Back with McClellan. Two on three. Stop by McEwen. Trottier. Penguin territory. Skates laterally. Right wing boards to Tonelli. Bullard puts him in against the wood, and Rod Schutt passes back to center. It'll go to Kevin McClellan. 2-0 game. Islanders lead. McClellan's shot blocked by Langevin. Loose in the Islanders zone. Smith plays it off the body of Rod Schutt. Bullard going after the puck. Play to the right side, and the Pens cannot keep it in. Randy Boyd. Pass picked off by Gilbert. Gilbert trying to get into the wards of the net. Can't make the play. Gets it back. Centers to Gorey. Shot score. Puts Gorey.
Gorey with his first playoff goal of the year. 27th of his career. Gilbert carries it in. Loses it. Right back out. There's Goring. You go upstairs with it up in the corner.
Islanders
inside the post.
First of the playoffs for number 91, Butch Goring. The assist went to number 17.
Here is Bourne. Shoot it. Islanders have it. And the Islanders break back 2-on-2. Bourne. Penguins in around Boyd. Comes down. And it's left on the near side. Gilbert bumped by Pat Price. Ferguson to the pins. Rink wide pass to Randy Boyd. Islanders now lead 3-0. And Boyd's able to clear it to center. Morrow. There's a Boyd now in a fight with Bourne. And they're going to it, and the Penguins in. Bob Bourne and Randy Boyd in a battle in the pins end. Boyd comes up trying to get his hands loose. They're still going to it. Boyd and Bobby Bourne. And the linesmen jump in. Scoring, Terry, on that goal by Gorey.
Butch Gorey with his first from Greg Gilbert. Goal came at 17-12. Islanders lead 3-0. Bourne and Randy Boyd will both head to the dressing rooms. They'll get 5 minutes each for fighting.
Yeah, we have 2:19 left here in the first period.
Pittsburgh penalty number 8, Randy Boyd. Islanders penalty number 14, Bob Bourne. 2 minutes for slashing, 5 minutes for fighting.
Well, they'll tack 2 minutes on for slashing on the Bob Bourne. So Pittsburgh will have the power play.
No, they both got slashing penalties there.
Two each for slashing,
yeah.
Five each
okay.
for fighting.
They both got minors.
17-41.
Well, the Islanders waited a while to open things up, but boy, when they did, they just put the pressure on. Bossy at 7:57 on a power play, then Merrick and Gorey connecting. They'll be at equal strength. Pens just lose Boyd and the Islanders Bourne for 7 minutes. And the Islanders with the puck. Here's Brent Sutter. Steps up to the Penguins line. Drop pass to Gillies. He's open. Throw it in front to Brent Sutter. Score.
Two goals in 41 seconds, three goals in 2.5 minutes, and the roof has caved in once again at the Coliseum. Brent Sutter goes in, low backhand pass set up for Gillies, right back to Brent Sutter, has the entire net to work with. Brent Sutter scores his second playoff goal.
Islanders goal, second of the playoffs, for number 21, Brent Sutter.
Ottawa Pittsburgh will pass it to Pat Price, and the puck goes through to the Islanders zone. We're going to have an icing call here. It'll be against Pittsburgh, and back they'll come. Now, I would think the Pens might consider not to put it on Dion's shoulders, but they might look for a change maybe in goal in the second period, trying to get a new life in there. They just haven't had it against the Islanders. They came out, played a pretty good first five. Turned around and then opened the door. So they're on top now 4-0 with a minute 52 left in the period. Malone, Penguin center iceman with Pat Buttet and Rick Kehoe.
That's 10 unanswered goals over two nights for the New York Islanders.
Price will send it away off the boards back to the Islander line. Langevin goes to Merrick and will wrap it back behind the Penguin net. Pat Price sends it near side to Hotham. He couldn't get Merrick to it. Merrick well to Gillies alone in the corner. In front. And a man there, and he just couldn't deflect it in. And the puck again bouncing back into Islander territory. Dave Langevin. Back to center. Hotham stops that play. Here's Keogh on the move to Malone. Malone is hit by Langevin. And the Islanders, you can bet your life now, will play a physical game in addition to freewheeling what they do best. They've got a 4-0 lead. They can afford to take some chances. Baxter right side. A shot stopped by Smith. Carlisle left wing boards. Shot. Keogh's in front. Can't get it to the net. Boutet has it. A Keogh shot. And again stopped.
Last minute of play.
1 minute to go in the period. Carlisle knocks over Dwayne Sutter. And the puck sails on edge all the way back to the Penguins end. Baxter defensively for the Penguins. Plays it softly to the red line. Potvin breaks it up to Trottier left wing. Here he comes. Trottier moves in. His shot. Dion stopped him with the right leg. Trottier has it again. In front to Nelly. Shot. Save again, Dion. Boutet fires it out of his own zone. 33 seconds left. Morrow to touch it. Icing call. Kenny Morrow trying to make it three Stanley Cup championships in a row. Came here as a rookie. Won the U.S. or the gold medal in the Olympics, playing on the U.S. team. He'll be able to play maybe two more years and retire with all the medals and all the gold. Just carry it off and check it in.
He'll get the tag, being a winner. That's what it is.
Seconds left, first period. The Islanders exploding here for four goals. And Baxter drives it off the boards. In a little over 2 minutes, they score three of them. Morrow to the far side. And it goes back into the Penguins' end. There'll be no icing. Carlisle's coming back, so is Trottier. Trottier works it free around the net. Baxter with the Penguins has it. He is checked. But he carries the puck out to the blue line. Now moves it up to center red. Into the left wing corner. Smith tried to play it on the hop. He couldn't do it. Trottier, 1 second. That's it. Well, the end of the first period. And look at the scoreboard. Shows the New York Islanders leading Pittsburgh 4-0.
Shots on goal.
And this is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Well, the Penguins will be returning home tomorrow. And hopefully
we don't get snowed in.
Yeah, I know. Boy, we've had some terrible weather here in the early part of April.
They're calling for 2 to 4 inches in the morning.
My understanding is it may have hit Pittsburgh already. So we should have a white Easter, I guess. We hope to show you some highlights before we get the second period underway, so bear with us on the TV side. The Penguins going tonight with seven rookies, and if nothing else, at least they'll get some experience in what the Stanley Cup playoffs are all about. And it's a tough way to break in, but you've got to start them somewhere, and of course, the Penguins in a rebuilding process with a lot of youth. And they have a long ways to go still. There's no question about that.
Well, one encouraging aspect for this year, we have our first and second round draft picks. Take a look now. Mike Bossy's goal came on a power play. Stefan Pearson Bossy with a quick shot. Go right between the legs. Michel Dion just couldn't close them quick enough. And the Islanders with that all-important first goal. Bossy, his second of the playoffs from Pearson. Brian Trottier picking up an assist to keep his streak 26 consecutive games. Then the puck comes out, and Wayne Merrick gets it, bounces off Paul Baxter's stick before he can recover. Merrick beats Dion to the glove side for a 2-0 lead. Greg Gilbert sets up Butch Goring for the third goal. That came at 17-12. Gilbert coming in, goes into the corner. The rookie playing in only his second game. Centers it right back to the slot for the veteran Wiley Butch Goring. Again, beats Dion on the glove side. Goring with his first playoff goal of the series. And then the last one, Brent Sutter carrying it across. Gives a backhand pass to Gillies. He breaks for the net. Takes the pass back from Sutter. Sutter with the backhander. And it's 4-0 New York first period. Shots the Islanders 17, Pittsburgh 11. We have an update on the one out of town game. Boston now leading Buffalo 4-1 in the second. Rick Middleton has two goals on the night, and rookie Barry Pettersson a pair of goals for the Bruins.
Well, Michel Dion in goal for the Penguins there. Billy Smith for the New York Islanders. Greg Malone with Pat Boutette and Steve Gatzos for the Pens. For the New York Islanders, it'll be Wayne Merrick at center with Dwayne Sutter in the right wing and Park Gillies. Lake Jethro on the left side, and the Pens control the draw. Carlisle skates to the Islanders zone, down the left side, throw it to the right wing corner. Gatzos is after it, he'll not get there. Gillies, snap it around the boards, near side for Dwayne Sutter. He is hit by Boutette from behind the net. Pearson gives the puck to Gillies. Move it right to Pearson. Right wing to Merrick, into the Penguins' end. Trying to beat Carlisle, cuts behind the goal. Merrick, knocked down by Carlisle. Dwayne Sutter, far corner. Malone got a piece of him. Merrick on the far wing. Trying to pass it back to Gillies. Carlisle breaks it up. Gatzo spins it away. Takes a check from Longevity, who sent him to his knees. And it goes back to the Islanders' end. Pearson's pass. Off Gillies' skates. Carlisle has it. Can he get in? It's onside. Carlisle dropped past to Malone. Couldn't handle it. And the Islanders steer it away. Baxter captures the puck. Skates his own blue line, coming all the way to the Islanders' zone now. He's hit by Longevin. They collide. Islanders have it. Here's Merrick on a breakaway. Boutette trying to hook him. Can't slow him down. Merrick comes in, and he can't get the shot off. Oh, Boutette had him with a stick all the way up ice. Tonelli's pass. Left side. A quick shot by Cowher. Missed the goal. Over to the Penguins. Somebody's without a glove. It's Tonelli at center ice. Mike Bower to the Penguins. Boutette was just going for the ride. He had his stick into Merrick. Here's Bower down. A weak shot, and it's stopped by Billy Smith. Trottier steers it behind the goal to Puntman. Out to Trottier. Trottier glides along the ice. Cuts inside on Price. Left the puck for Tonelli. Tonelli trying to find someone open. Callard gets it right point. It goes to Morrow. Behind the net to Trottier. He goes to it far side. Spins it behind the net to Tonelli. Tonelli, hard-working left winger. Crisscross with Trottier. Back to Tonelli. A shot. Stopped by Diard. And Hoppum. Move it around to the near way. Rick McQuaise crunched by Morrow. And it comes to center. Callard's pass to Trottier. Too far for Tonelli. And the Penguins able to pick it off. Pat Price looks ahead for Ferguson. Into the Islanders' end he goes. Forgot the puck, however. And here's Anders Keller. Going rink wide. Board was knocked down. Craig Gilbert steps up to the Penguin blue line. Throws it to the right wing corner, and McLeish of the Penguins back to handle the puck. We'll pass it around for Hotham. Hotham's pass off an Islander. There'll be no icing. Comes the length of the ice, and Billy Smith, like the Statue of Liberty, just reaches out. Drops it over to Gordie Lane. Right wing pass to Brent Sutter. Man open, left wing Gilbert. Penguins in. Comes down against Baxter, trying to get around him. Centers it. Shot. Brent Sutter had an opportunity there. Randy Carlisle wasting no time. He'll scoot back quickly. Almost 3 minutes into the second period. Left wing of Cigarot. Lane watches him center, and it goes over the right side. Baxter, a quick shot, and that is up high. Good save by Billy Smith. Here are the Islanders, 3-on-2. Brent Sutter, right side. Drop pass to Goring. Tried to tap it over to Gilbert. Could not connect. Loose puck. Brent Sutter with a backhand shot. Good attempt there, but he missed the net. Kevin McClellan, Penguin right winger. Rolls it to Rod Shutt. Going to fake a shot. Islanders in. To the right of Billy Smith. Leaves the puck after McClellan and McEwen. And the Islanders with John Tonelli in control of the disc. Pass it out. Brent Sutter and Pat Price collide. Here's Malone of the Penguins with it. Gives it back to Price. Left point. Weak shot. And it's stolen by Gordie Lane. He sneaks it back to center. Price checked by Brent Sutter. Islander territory. Left wing of Boutette, a long shot. He missed the goal. Right point. Hotham keeps it in. His shot back to the net. Billy Smith reaches up and holds on. We'll take a break. The score, the Penguins trailing the Islanders 4-0, and this is the Penguins Hockey Network. 16-13 left, second period. Game two of this playoff series. The Islanders lead the series 1-0, and they will get the faceoff on their own end. Malone against Wayne Merrick, and Merrick won the draw. Pearson's pass, left side to Clark Gillies. Checked by the Penguins. Malone falls down. It comes to Keogh. He blasted wide. Keogh gets another chance at it. Smith stops him. In behind the net, Smith yelling to his teammates to freeze the puck.
Out of town, Terry O'Reilly has scored for the Bruins, and Craig Ramsey for Buffalo. Scores now 5-2. Boston in the second period. Rangers and Flyers are tied at 1-1, but we don't have the goal scorers just yet for that game.
That game, of course, starting at 8:30 Eastern Time, due to the circus being in New York. It's always a circus there, isn't it? That's down the road from here a little bit, from the island.
There's only one safe place to go in New York. That's OTP.
Amen. Mr. Corrigan, the assistant coach, and I went over just for a brief time today. Oh, enjoyed it immensely. Enjoyed
be sure
it.
You report those with the IRS on the 15th of this month.
We got enough trouble. Those are 82 earnings anyway. Here's Malone against Merrick, and the puck in between the circles. And Dwayne Sutter sneaks it back to center red. Price. Near side, it comes to Pearson. Up ahead to Wayne Merrick. Going left wing to Trottier. Trottier out here on the backhand. Shoots it wide. He's going to go off here. The Islanders put Gillies back on the wing. Greg Malone, Penguin center iceman, back to the Islanders stripe. A quick blast, and Smith made a good save there. Hotham is hit by Gillies. Keogh in the corner, taken out of the play by Longeberg. Malone goes in, and again, the Islanders will freeze the puck.
Do you have to declare more than $12? On there?
I saw your pocket. It's just a bulging. You better get a bodyguard to get out of here tonight.
Price warned by referee Andy Van Hulleman about something. Well, the Penguins making a change now. They'll put out fresh troops. Mike Bullard with Rick McLeish and George Ferguson. Pat Price will go off. He's been booed every time he touches the puck here in New York by this Islander crowd.
Bobby Clark has scored for the Flyers. And Carol Vadney, two senior citizens, getting their first playoff goals. Flyers and Rangers 1-1.
Baxter Carlisle defensively, the puck to the Islander goal. Smith just almost seems to be going through the motions there in goal for the Islanders here tonight. Carlisle trying to get in, he can't. Does it so effortlessly, does Smith, when he's on his game. And he comes out, sweeps it over to the far corner. Bullard of the Penguins will get the puck now, misplays it. Morrow trying to put him into the corner boards, and he will. Morrow just does all the little things that a good defenseman should do at the right time. Here is McLeish, near side. Carlisle could not get a handle on the puck, and it goes back to the Penguin stripe. Baxter passing left wing to McLeish. And he will bounce the puck, Islander territory. Dennis Potvin. Roll it over to John Tinelli. Tinelli to Dennis Potvin, gave it away. Here's McLeish. Shoot it wide of the net. Baxter right point. Where'd that one go? Hit a body. It's still loose. McLeish's shot. The save made. Rebound. McLeish scores on the rebound. And the Penguins make it 4-1. Great balls of fire. Rick McLeish, fifth leading scorer all time in Stanley Cup playoff history, gets another one.
That's his 54th of his career, but first of this series. Penn's putting a little bit of pressure on. McLeish with the first shot. Ferguson's tied up, can't get to the rebound. McLeish comes in, goes upstairs with the backhand, and the Pens are on the board. Goal comes at 5:32 of the second period.
Trotty had his skates tied up with Mike Bullard. Bullard raised his arms as he was on the ice. Gordy Lane takes a crack at Pat Price, a puck into the Penguins end. Off the near wing, digging forward is Rod Schutt. Pittsburgh trying to come back here now. They're down 4-1. It goes into the Islanders' zone. McEwen moves it right back to the Penguin blue line.
Number 22, Mike Bullard.
Gordy Lane. The Bob Bourne. Goring had a poke check by Hotham.
From Ferguson and Bullard at 5:32.
Islanders again setting the attack up from their own end of the rink. Gordy Lane up the sideboards. It's touched by Hotham. Rolls it to Andre Sagaron. Back to Hotham. Right wing to Kevin McQuillan. Snap it to the Islanders' left wing corner. Gordy Lane in. Near board. Watches Bourne move it back to center. The Islanders now is systematically clearing the puck out of their own end. Hotham looked ahead for Rod Schutt. Schutt and Goring both cannot get to the disc, and the puck rolls back into Penguin territory. Carlisle to the left of Dion. Move it quickly left wing to Rod Schutt. Here he comes. Islander line. Long shot on Billy Smith. He'll make the save, and Schutt will chase off here. Gordy Lane round to the far wing for Gillies. He looks for the opening, has a man. Brent Sutter, Dwayne is open on the right side, couldn't get it through. Carlisle stopped the play nicely. Gordy Lane with a puck up the right side to Gillies. Gillies passing to Dwayne Sutter. Baxter takes him heavily to the boards on a good check. From the near wing, Malone of Pittsburgh lost it. Here's Gillies, a shot, save made by Dion. Far wing, Gillies over to Brent Sutter. Back to the left point, open is Longevin. Going to shoot it, let it go, it hit a leg in front. Malone out to Keogh. Here are the pins, 3-on-2. A chance here. Keogh, Malone, and Boutette. Islander zone. Keogh down left wing. Boutette's open, and a great defensive play by Pearson. Oh, Pearson just made the defensive player of the series. Wayne Sutter, Gilly's open left wing. He's got him. His shot is scored.
Game, how to go from defense to offense in one quick step, and that's just exactly what the Islanders did. Pens are coming down 3-on-2. Stefan Pearson breaks it up, taking the puck away from Pat Boutette, moves it out to Dwayne Sutter. Sutter and Gillies coming down on a 2-on-1. Sutter with a perfect pass, Gillies scoring from the identical spot where he scored last night, and the Islanders now lead 5-1. Gillies from Dwayne Sutter.
Can you give Pearson an assist?
They didn't give him one.
No, I know that. You have to. He just made a brilliant defensive play. Penguins at a 3-on-2. Never got anything out of it. Pearson diving to the ice to block the play on Boutette. Now back to the Penguin zone. Here's John Tinelli. Tinelli near corner. Price puts him into the corner boards. Penguins digging for it. Trottier has it. Look out. He walks in. His shot saved. Rebound in front. Here's Haller, and he can't shoot it in. Price has Tinelli down in the Penguin zone. Here's McLeish. Can't get around Longeman. Bullard waits for Ferguson to get onside. Circles at center red. Bullard takes off against Pearson. Got through him, but the puck went to the net. Knocked away by Smith. McLeish keeps it in. 5-1 game. Islanders lead. Ferguson looking for Hotham breaking into the Islanders zone. Can't get it to Greg Hotham. And it's the Islanders with a puck. Here they come. Right side. Keller. Offside play. Let's take a break. 11:37 left in period number two. The Islanders lead it 5-1. And this is the Penguins Hockey Network. Barry Peterson has the hat trick.
It's now 6-2 Boston. Guy Lafleur has scored for Montreal. It's 1-1. Montreal and Quebec.
It's 5-1 here. And Rod Shutt of the Penguins bring it back to the Islanders zone. Left point. Pass to Singeron. He's got some room. He puts it in front of McClellan and hit goaltender Smith in the mask. Bounced up and the Penguins couldn't get it in. Shut to Baxter. Slap shot. And it's stopped by Billy Smith. Shut in the near corner. Take it in. McClellan battling. He centers it out. To Baxter. Stops it with a glove. Can he shoot it? Got to go back to the net. Stopped by Smith in front. He skates with a puck and holds on. Smith has been a model citizen so far in the first two games.
I was just checking the record book last year. Of course, this year during the regular season, he had 24 penalty minutes, including six there in the last game of the season. Last year, in all the games he played in the playoffs, he only had two. So you know he does a lot of it just for show and just to get attention. But when it comes time, when the money's on the line, Billy Smith has one job to do and one job only, and that's stop the puck.
Puck came off Morrow's skates and hit Smith right in the mask. Lady Luck going with him right there. Malone on the right side. Price had it knocked away by Gilbert. One man to beat, Randy Boyd. Gilbert has it go off his stick. He goes in deep, centers it back, comes out of Bourne, right side. Boyd made him pay the price as he took him into the board. Far wing, Penguins out. It comes free to Gilbert in front, Corey there. Look out, his shot. The stop is made by Meech, Shell Dion. In front again, Bourne, shot, save, rebound. Stopped again by Dion. Rebound, Gilbert, he can't shoot it. Price of the pen. Tried to clear. Lane. Kept it in. Gilbert and Price collide. Boutette along the near side. Digging for it. Finally plays it to Malone. Keogh on the right side. Has him in stride. Slap shot. Missed the net. Bourne starts it right back. Goring 2-on-2 with Gilbert. Goring moving in. Oh, nice move. Goring trying to leave it for Bourne. He couldn't do it. Price took Goring down. Might have been a penalty there. Baxter of the Penguins. Off the near wing to Pat Boutette. He's tired. He wants to face it off. Freezing. We're almost halfway home in the hockey game. The New York Islanders with a 5-1 lead. Gillies, Brent Sutter, Butch Goring, Wayne Merrick, and Mike Bossy have scored. McLeish, the only goal getter for the Penguins. Goring alone, 1-on-1. Trying to go the short side. He had the net there, but he just missed it. Bullard and Merrick, and the puck dropped kind of unfairly there. The Penguins won the draw. Here is Rick McLeish passing to Mike Bullard, and the Bullard starts it up. Gilly stops it. McLeish takes off right side to Baxter, throw it back to the net, and it is controlled by Billy Smith. Langevin move it up to center, now to Wayne Merrick. Blast it off the boards, and it comes around the near wing. Bullard digging for it, and they'll freeze it. And that faceoff will be in the Penguins' end again. We'll take a break, and the score, 5-1, New York. This is the Penguins Hockey Network. The Islanders working on game number two here with a 5-1 lead. Game three will be in Pittsburgh on Saturday night. Bullard back to Randy Carlyle on the near side of his own zone. Pass it up the left side. McLeish up to center to Bullard. 2-on-2. Look for Ferguson. Can't find the puck now himself. And here come the Islanders. Going right back. Drop pass to Dwayne Sutter. Look for Merrick off his skates. Baxter stops it for the Penguins and just plays it softly back to center ice. Dave Langevin off the boards. Merrick rolls it deep. Around the boards. McLeish. And McLeish bumped by Dwayne Sutter. Here is Bourne racing back. Penguins in. Down the right side. Comes to the near corner. Leaves it for Dwayne Sutter. Tied up by McLeish. And they will freeze it. Well, Sutter that time did something that you're going to find good teams doing, too. He had McLeish alone on the left wing. McLeish had room, and he just bumped him. He just made him pay the price for being there. That's something the Penguins have not done in this series. You got to make them think. Maybe hit him once, maybe twice, maybe three times, and maybe they're a little bit slower the next time. Not where you're physically abusing people and drawing penalties, but just good, clean hockey.
Chicago and Minnesota scored us after one period of play. There's been a goaltending change in Boston. Paul Harrison, formerly of the Pittsburgh Penguins, has replaced Don Edwards in goal. Sabres trailing 6-2. Minnesota has gone to Don Beaupre tonight using Jules Meloche last night. Murray Bannerman back in goal for Chicago, who was outstanding last night with 40-some saves.
Billy Carroll getting some ice time now with a 5-1 lead. Bobby Bourne and Brent Sutter. And McClellan takes a check from Bob Bourne. Is put in behind the net. Pat Price of the Penguins passes it to Andre Singeron. Circling. Goes right side to McClellan. It's just a bit too far, and it goes back to the Islanders' zone. Billy Smith says, hey, I'll take it. And he will give it to the Islanders. Big defenseman Dennis Putvin. Left side pass to Billy Carroll, slowed by Rod Shutt. Turn around, McClellan in there checking also. They force it back in the corner, and Putvin will corral it. Putvin swings to the left of his own net. Up the center of the ice to Brent Sutter. Boy, he just picked that defense apart, threw it up the alley, right to Brent Sutter's stick. Up on the near side. Penguin territory, and the Penguins work it free. Rod Shutt passing left side to Hotham. Hotham backhanded away behind the New York goal. And here is Potvin again. Penguins trying to make a line change here. Perfect pass to Brent Sutter. Needed on the backhand. Behind the net, Dion. Dion around, far side. Keller moves in against Keogh. Plays with the corner, Malone. Penguin center iceman got by Keller and finds Keogh at center circle. Islanders in. Trying to pass it back to Malone. Went to the far corner. Here's McEwen. Around the horn, near wing. Boutette of the Penguins digging. Pass behind Keogh. The Islanders storm out 2-on-2. Wayne trails the play. Tonelli on the left wing. Nice play. Got around Baxter trying to keep his balance. He went down. Still gets back up. Keogh takes him in behind the net. And now Baxter hits him with a good check behind the goal. Trottier slams Malone against the boards. Knocks him down. Islanders back to the net. Loose puck in front. It goes in. Islanders would not be enough.
Into John Tonelli, who worked like a coal miner earlier to get it. Finally just bounces one up in the air, gets over Michel Dion's leg, and it's 6-1 the New York Islanders. Earlier on that shift, Tonelli just almost crawled the length of the ice to get the puck into the offensive zone. And he just keeps working. Baxter trying to tie him up. just under the arm, over the leg.
Time of the goal,
Antonelli with his first playoff goal.
Antonelli from Trottier and McEwen at 12:51.
Here are the Islanders again. Bourne back to Goring. Got around McQuaid, threw it to the net. Nobody there to deflect it in. And Mike Bullard of Pittsburgh skates back to the Islanders' stripe. He moves down, drop pass to McQuaid. He is open. His wrist shot down low. Smith to save. And he covers up. We'll take a break. At the moment, it's the Islanders 6, Pittsburgh 1. And this is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Fans are booing because the crosstown rival, New York Rangers, taking a 2-1 lead against the Flyers on a goal by Ron Duguay.
Islanders led 4-0 at the end of the first period. It is now 6-1 New York. Bob Bourne, the Butch Goring. Penguin territory, try to get around a man, leaves the puck for Bourne. Checked by Bullard, throws him into the board, launch him in left point, a shot stop. Goring's got the rebound, backhander, he missed the net. McLeish of the fans. To the left wing, to Mike Bullard. Right side to Ferguson, cranks it up, long range. On Smith, he was fooled by it, but he made the save. The rebound's in front, Pearson to his knees, clears it away from the goal. Langevin back to Stefan Pearson. Pearson, 27-year-old defenseman, play it right wing to Goring. Goring's had a pretty good series here. Dumps it behind the net, and Pat Price on defense to Rick McLeish. Pass just beyond the reach of McClellan. Going for it is Smith. He's going to dive out and take the puck before McClellan can get there. And rookie Kevin McClellan trying to get in there, and Billy Smith came out. Smith will be a veteran of 10 years after this season is all done in the NHL. There you see Smith coming up. Potvin had McClellan tied up anyway.
Pretty dangerous play by the veteran, but gets the faceoff. 5:51 remaining in the second period. The Islanders 6, the Penguins 1.
Randy Carlisle and Paul Baxter handling the defense now for the Pens. Singerot, Schutt, and McClellan. Merrick, Trottier, and Brent Sutter. Merrick handled the faceoff. Schutt has the puck. Played away to Dwayne Sutter. To Merrick. Man open left wing. Trottier off the stick. And it went to the Penguins' net area. Rod Schutt turns and throws it back to center ice. Singerot has it. Passing rink wide to Kevin McClellan. Islanders in, trying to beat Potvin. He'll stand him up nicely. He'll push and shove a little bit. Potvin rearranges his chin strap. The puck dropped long to the Penguins. Oh, Dion has to play the puck. Wayne Sutter coming in. Dion to the near boards for Singerot. Takes the check from Merrick, who just put the body into him. Simple little play. Here comes Baxter, back right side. Gillies into the corner. Trying to take it away. Can't do it. The Penguins watch Morrow now handle the puck. He lost it. Singerot. McCollins in front of the net. Singerot trying to deke around Potvin. Can't do it. Potvin left wing to Gillies. Out to the blue line. Baxter trying to keep it in. It went outside. He carried it back in. He gave it a valiant effort. Unable to hold it. 6-1. The Islanders lead. Timeout here from the Nassau County Coliseum. And this is the Penguins Hockey Network. Mike Lang along with Terry Schiffauer here. York. Brian Trottier with John Tinelli and Anders Keller. Well, they haven't had to use Bossy, and boy, that's a big break. Keller right side, great pass by Trottier. Comes in. Shooting the puck and went up the side of the net. Gets it back, centers it in front. Gatzos tried to clear, he couldn't do it. McEwen with a shot. Gatzos got that. Malone of the Pens. That centered, taken away from him by the Islanders. Gordy Lane to Tinelli. Tinelli. Scoots quickly to the Penguins' end. Down, trying to beat two men, and the odd snaps it away. Price knocked down Tinelli. Gatzos in his own end of the rink. Rink wide pass to Pat Buttet. Look to get it to Malone. Off a skate, it comes to Malone. Weak shot. Knocked away by Billy Smith. Gatzos in. Keller gets the puck up to Tinelli. 4:08 left, second period. Tinelli a blind pass. We'll see the Islanders do that too often. Expected somebody to be there. Gatzos turned it over to the Islanders' blue line area. Mike McEwen, good skating defenseman, finds Keller open. Good pass to Goring. Goring, Penguins in. Takes off on the right side. Hotham to beat. Cuts inside. Put it in front. A backhand shot by Tinelli. Stopped by Michel Dion. Speed did it for Goring that time. and Tonelli was right in front of the net. I think he lives there. Just good hard work coming in. Leans into the play. Scoring back. A shot by Tonelli. Dion with the save. St. Louis leading Winnipeg 1-0 on a goal by Brian Sutter. First period action there. Scoring against Bullard, and Bullard pulled it back for Randy Carlisle. Finds Bullard at the center circle. Pulls up, wristed over to the right wing corner of the Islanders' zone. Billy Smith back behind the net. Pearsall, right wing to Bourne. The Islanders are open again. Off Goring stick, but it's picked up by Gilbert. In front to Goring. Bourne on the far side. Ferguson took a whack at it, and he does clear. Send it right back to center. Where the Penguins are content just to get the puck out of their own end, the Islanders just keep pouring it on, and they freeze the puck. 3 minutes and 8 seconds left here in period number two.
It was the Boston Buffalo score 6-2, Terry, at the end of two. Sorry, didn't hear. 6-2, Boston leading Buffalo.
Peterson with the hat trick, Middleton with a pair, and O'Reilly. Islanders just working a perfect play, waiting. Goring cuts for the middle. Pass just a little too far.
Dennis Potvin to Brent Sutter. Off the stick of Segarant. And Dennis Potvin will get it again. Right back to the Penguin line. Randy Boyd, who was involved in a fight earlier with Bob Bourne of the Islanders. Pass comes far side. Potvin rams McCullough to the boards. And Kevin McCullough, 6'2", right winger, wraps it back in behind Billy Smith. Penguins have a goal in this period. The Islanders have two. They're up 6-1. Billy Carroll to center. Singeron able to pick that up. Sirkling lost it. Look out. Here's Carroll back against Boyd. Carroll comes in, turning, looks for a trailer. Knocked down. Penalty coming up Pittsburgh. Boyd floating down. And we will take a break. Penalty against Randy Boyd. 6-1 New York. This is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Us got through the second period without a penalty being called, but Randy Boyd is hit for a hook for holding at 17:35. Islanders with their fourth power play chance of the game. Take a look at the play. Billy Carroll coming in. Boyd comes in. Carroll tries to stop in a diamond spin, and Boyd just pulls him right away.
The Islanders on the power play. First goal of the night. Game with a man advantage. And Merrick with Dwayne Sutter and Clark Gillies. Gillies in front of that net again. Dwayne Sutter, left point, has McEwen. Slap shot, stopped in front by Carlisle. And he will pass the puck off to Pat Boutet. Boutet and Ferguson, the penalty killers for Coach Eddie Johnston. And Boutet rolls it away off the boards and behind the Islander cage. Mike McEwen looks for Merrick, has him. Right side to step on Pearson. Skates the Penguin blue line. Drop pass, nice to open space to McEwen. Cuts in, he's got some room. His shot stopped by Dion. They let him go. And McEwen almost scored a goal. Right point, Pearson moves in. His hard shot stopped by Dion. Oh, he tried to blast that one right between his legs. 1 minute and 23 seconds left. And look at Michel Dion on the TV side. Pearson all the wood to it. Dion there with the leather to stop it. You can see the insignia on, can't you?
It says made in St. Louis, Missouri.
Only you and all your wisdom would know that.
It's going to take you to the end of the game to prove me wrong until you get down and look at one.
.123 to go in the Boyd penalty. A minute 48 to go in the period. Islanders on a power play. Leading 6-1. Left side. Here's Potvin back to the center point. And it came outside the blue line. Pearson. Played it back in. So the offside play called against the New York Islanders. Islanders have spread the scoring around tonight. And they have Trottier out here with Keller and John Tonelli. Tonelli, just 24 years old. Played at the WHA before he came to the Islanders. And a very impressive hockey player. Here's Price shooting the puck long to the Islander zone. That will take some of the heat out of the kitchen. Potvin lead pass right on the money. Boy, just passes of him brilliant tonight. Trottier, right side, gives it to Pearson. Cut around a man, comes in, his shot hits the post. Boutet plays it off the boards. Oh, Pearson. And he has had a strong game for the Islanders here this evening. Stefan Pearson.
Last night it was Kenny Morrow. Tonight it's Stefan Pearson.
Swedish player going to center ice to Trottier. Right wing to Anders Keller. Stop. At the blue line, he can't go in. And Chorney with the puck to Sengaron. Takes the shot. And a jumping Billy Smith made the save. 30 seconds to go on the penalty. Islanders rush right back. Waste no time. Trottier comes in. Hops around Chorney. He's alone. In on goal. Put it in front. And it's blocked on the way. He tended it for Tonelli. Trying to make that perfect little pass. Trottier just hopped by Mark Chorney. Potvin, 13 seconds to go on the penalty. Cruising back at center. Oh, a lead pass off Bornstick. Just misfired. Dion clears. Left point. Potvin has it again. Again on the money pass to Born. Born to the near corner. Penalty is over. 23 seconds to go in the period. Behind the net to Born. Goring's alone. Born's going to try and come out. He'll pass it over instead to Potvin. Turning shot. And the save is made by Dion. Randy Boyd of Pittsburgh. Off the stick of Gilbert. Goes back to Penguin territory. Chorney's pass. 5 seconds to go. Back for Chorney. And the second period will end. And that is it. The end of two. The Islanders lead the Penguins. New York 6 and Pittsburgh 1. And this is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Malibu classes.
We are back here at the Nassau County Coliseum, where the New York Islanders are leading the Penguins 6-1. Just checking the shots on goal. Tonelli has 4 for the Islanders to pace their attack. Baxter has 4 for the Pens. Rick McLeish has 3, all those coming in the second period. Mr. Trottier now has a 27-game scoring streak in National Hockey League playoff action. Here's a look at some of the highlights here. The Penguins' only goal tonight. Rick McLeish.
It's McLeish's 54th in his career. Of course, he scored the cup winner for the Flyers in 1974. Also one of 11 players to score 3 goals in one period in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
And here is the final goal, Trottier. Malone is out of the play. In front, Tonelli.
Is that Cheryl Tiggs to your right there, trying to get
on
television?
About Cheryl Tiggs. You know, when she was on New York the other night, she went out with Ron Duguay. That was a big scoop.
Come on.
I'll be right back.
Maybe she will. Come on.
Come on, overtime.
I have a guest. That's pause for station identification. This is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Watch Sha-na-na, greasier and crazier than ever. Weekdays at 6:30 here on WPTT. Television 22, Pittsburgh.
All right, third period is underway. Dennis Potvin with a puck.
You know who that is, Terry?
No.
That's Mrs. McEwen. That's Mike McEwen's lovely wife.
She wouldn't be up here in the cheap seats.
Back behind the Penguin goal. Wide shot of the Penguins trying to bring it out. He drops it back to Paul Baxter. Turned around by Bob Bourne. But Baxter carries a mail. Coming to the Islander line. Shot. Fell down. Went in offside on the play. Just unable to keep his balance. Well, the Penguins have game 3 at the arena on Saturday night. We didn't get an attendance figure tonight, did we?
They were short of capacity here last night. Of course, with
they do have it. 15,230. Montreal and Quebec are tied 2-2. Côté and Nylund have scored in that game.
The holiday season into effect. They're a little bit short of a sellout. You know what the top ticket goes for here at the Island? To watch the Islanders in action? $26. Billy Smith behind the net. Langevin right side. Out to center. Pierce, a man wide open. Gilbert, he's got a chance breakaway. Alone on goal. His shot, he scores. His first National Hockey League goal. It comes in Stanley Cup playoff action.
Might not be his first. I think he's got one early.
That's right.
One game.
seconds into the third and final period. The Islanders have now scored the Pens 15-2 in two nights' work. Perfect lead pass goes in.
He had space great between move. The legs. Yes, it was a great
goal. Move. His first of the playoffs for number 17, Greg Gilbert.
I have a feeling we'll be talking about the next Bob Gainey. Right here.
21, Brent Sutter. Time of the goal.
Boy, he might be a defensive
seconds.
Player, but he's got all the talent
Gilbert,
to score, too.
And Brent Sutter at 40 seconds.
Took the pass from Stefan Pearson. Brent Sutter also assisting on the play.
7-1 New York. Islanders score 40 seconds into the third period. Price is passed to Bullard at center. Ferguson shoots it in. Somebody in the crowd has a whistle here. Callert sends it away to John Tinelli. Tinelli into the Penguins end. Drop pass. McLeese broke up that play. And Rick McLeese drives it off the boards. Bullard's going after it. Potvin rides him into the boards. Takes him out of the play. The Islander defense tonight as a unit has just been outstanding. Bullard back to the Penguin line for Randy Boyd. Plays it by Anders Cowher. McLeese sweeps at it and he goes into the New York zone. We've played a minute and a half here of period number three. The Islanders in command of the game, 7-1. Trottier swings his way to the Penguins end to Cowher. Back in front of the net for John Tinelli. Tinelli just keeps going to that cage. Rick McLeese gliding along the ice. Gordy Lane to beat. Had a half a step on him. Takes the backhand shot. Billy Smith seemed to know exactly what he was going to do with that puck. Just stood his ground. Gordy Lane. Right wing pass. Dwayne Sutter can't get there. Pat Graham comes on for the Penguins. And the puck off the stick of Brent Sutter goes into the Islanders end. McEwen throws it away from the slot area. Near corner. Graham throws it in behind the net. Gordy Lane, New York defenseman, moves it right back to center red. Dwayne Sutter trying to beat Carlisle. Has a half a step on him. Can't quite get through to get it to Gillies, and the Penguins counterattack. Gatto's right wing. Trying to turn McEwen around. Takes the shot. Smith reaches up with a glove. And from the near side, New York territory, McEwen finds Merrick alone at center. Off Sutter's stick, Dwayne Sutter. Into the Penguins' right wing corner. Carlisle and Dwayne Sutter go in. Following the play, Merrick goes to Gillies. Turning shot. Save made. Islanders following up very well. Over the glass into the Coliseum crowd here, and we'll take a break. 17:23 to go, third period, 7-1 New York, and this is the Penguins Hockey Network. The Islanders with Wayne Merrick. I might expect Billy Carroll to get some more ice time here in this third period with the Islanders so far in front, and Mike Bossy just taking a rest. Now Larber just sitting back. If he hasn't fallen asleep coaching the club, it comes back up in the air, back to the Islander blue line, and it is controlled there by Langevin to Gillies. Back to Langevin. Pearson circling, dancing with that puck. Gives it to Langevin around Gardner. Up to the center of the ice to Dwayne Sutter. Into the Penguins' end, trying to get around that net. It comes in front. Quick shot, and that's just wide. Rebound comes in front, and the Penguins do control the puck. Up to Boutette. Islander strike. Drops it in. Comes off the boards, picked up by Gardner, a quick shot. That stopped. Gardner, left point to Chorney. Chorney's blast in front. Langevin clears it out. Dwayne Sutter had to go by a stick. He's going to get off the ice now. Tired line. Chorney finds Keogh to the left wing to Sengaron. Sengaron cuts it around. Nice play, but Pearson knocked it away at the last second. Rides Sengaron to the boards. Pearson doing it all on the near wing. New York territory. Jam up, and Merrick, who's been on a long time, does clear the puck from his own end and chases off. Keel, who has been held scoreless by the Islanders. Baxter and Gillies collide. The puck sent back to the near corner. Shot takes a piece of Dave Langevin, and it is wheeled up by the Islanders down to the Penguins' left wing corner. Price back to play. We played 4 minutes here in the third period. Islanders have scored once. Lead 7-1. McClellan to the Islander zone. Comes down that left side, put it in front off Smith's stick. To the left point, Randy Boyd. Boyd in front, a deflection by Rod Schutt, went wide of the goal. Price of the Penguins at the right point. Billy Carroll is on here for the Islanders, kick free. And it trickles back into the Penguin cage area. Randy Boyd, young rookie defenseman. Go into the veteran Price, up the right wing to McClellan. Centered. Sagarant to Schutt. He couldn't handle the pass. He's turned around by Morrow. Comes back to the right side. McClellan and Carroll both overskate, but it'll be punt ban. Avoids a check by Rod Shutt. Pass through to center to Brent Sutter. Left side, Carroll, a shot off the boards. The save is made. And Singer on. Gets to that rebound. Slowly to the center of the ice. Around Keller, trying to beat Morrow. He stands him up. Bumped away from the puck, and did his punt bag. Corrals it. Wristing it long, in on Dion. To the near wing for George Ferguson. Skating back behind his own goal. Drop pass to Randy Carlisle. Off him, gets the pass from Carlisle. Right wing to Ferguson. Back to Carlisle. Offside play called against the Penguins. Well, our thanks tonight to Bob Palumbo, who helped us out here. John Miller, who handled the audio. Folks who put together a fine telecast here in the New York area. Brian Seif, our producer from Pittsburgh and TBC.
The only problem with the guys in New York, they use that same script every night. Islanders jump on top, stay on top. To find a new ending to one of these games.
Gordy Lane wheels it back to center. Hotham of the Penguins right there. And finds board open. Blasted deep into the Islanders' net area. Smith handles it to McEwen. Has an easy time bringing it out. Up to Gilbert, who scored on a breakaway here early in the third period. Gilbert down, drop pass to Bourne. Nice play. Bourne a shot, and that's gloved by Dion. He's going to hold on to it. We are 5:54 into the final period. It is 7-1. Islanders over the Penguins. This is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Just tied an NHL record by scoring 3 goals and also had 4 points in one period. You know who the last player to score 3 goals in one Stanley Cup playoff period is.
We're behind the Penguin goal. Trottier centers for Keller, and he can't connect. Rick McLeish rushing back for the Penguins. And here's a penalty coming up. Trottier hauled down. Mike Bullard, Penguins. Dion's going to come off here now, but the Islanders have control. Bullard was knocked down by Trottier. He'll get an interference call. Trottier is an amazing individual. Here is the game, 7-1. He continues to punish people.
Trottier gets 2 minutes for interference at 6:13.
The Islanders 2 for interference at 6:13.
Pittsburgh will get just their second power play chance of the game. Trottier penalized both times.
I think you call that leading by example.
This is true.
Yeah.
I'll give you a hint on that player.
Yeah, would you?
The last player to score 3 in one period. He's in tonight's game.
Would it be number 7?
No.
No.
He is one of them, though. He has scored 3 in one period.
Well, that's enough. That's all I had to do was guess one.
No, the last one to do it.
Oh, the last one.
It's been a while.
Oh.
It's been since 1978, since George Ferguson scored 3. Oh, I gave you the answer.
Amanda Pellis of Indiana, PA, in our Foodland Power Play. Citizens Watch from Rogers. Jewers on the line. The Islanders deflected away. Rolling on edge. Funny roll into the Penguin zone. Baxter and Carlisle work the points. It's Gardner, Keogh, and Boutette up front. 13:30 left in the final period. The Islanders have total command of this game. They shoot it away to the Penguin zone. Billy Carroll and Goring, the penalty killers. Gardner works it free. He'll pass it back to Kehoe. And finds Carlisle open. Checked by Goring. Bouncing puck, Islanders ice. Here's Potvin, probably the strongest player clearing the puck in the National Hockey League from his own end. At least his wrists are so strong, he just snaps that puck out of his own zone. Carlisle back in the Pittsburgh end. The Islanders bottoming up the Penguin attack. Carroll gets a piece of Baxter, but he does skate it up. He's turned around to Carlisle. Minute 3 to go on the penalty to Trottier. Looks for some room. Skates it in. Potvin hit him. He goes on to the right wing corner. Potvin, oh, he punches him with a good heavy check. And the Islanders continue to make the Penguins pay the price. Keogh behind the net to Gardner. Out to Keogh. Keogh comes in, and his shot deflected. Nothing on it. Gardner, right point. It goes to Baxter. Baxter, left side. Carlisle, shot blocked by Morrow. Carlisle gets it back. In front, he's there. Smith the save. Rebound. And Gardner can't put it in. He's decked by Morrow. Keogh kicks it free to Carlisle. 20 seconds to go. Left point. Boutette. The right side by Baxter. And Baxter at center red. runs into his own man. Off the stick of Gardner. Brent Sutter, 2 seconds to go on the Trottier penalty. And the Islanders storm up again. Potvin. Around Malone, down the near side, in front for Sutter, and it's off his stick. Gillies keeps it in. Back to Gillies. Shot. Blocked. Loose in front. Dion steers it away. Malone. Hit by Dwayne Sutter. And it comes back to Sutter. 11:20 to go. In the third period. Price and Gillies go into the near corner. And it's an icing call. We will take a break. The score, the New York Islanders 7, the Penguins 1, and this is the Penguins Hockey Network. In New York territory, the faceoff to the right of Billy Smith. And allowed a goal to the Penguins last night at an 8-1 victory. The Islanders up 7-1 here, third period. And Stefan Pearson of the Islanders plays it over to Dave Langevin, left wing to Gillies. He failed on an attempted pass, leave it at center ice for Pearson. No, now colliding are two Penguins, and here's Gillies. Back into the Penguins' end. Skates the right side, try to go to the right point to Dwayne Sutter, went by. Langevin runs into the referee, John D'Amico. Going to bring you some updates on the scoreboard here in a moment. Gillies right side into Penguin ice. Graham stops it to Gatzos and back to Pat Price. Left wing. Off the skates of Graham, he is knocked down by Brad Sutter, and the Islanders come back. And Dwayne Sutter sneaks it long to the Penguins' end. Pat Price out the right wing, looking for Malone. McEwen comes over to clear away. Approaching the halfway point of the third period. Malone's pass to Gatzos. Long shot in. It's an offside call. Cut Smith up high. Graham was ahead of the left wing.
New York Rangers now lead Philadelphia 4-2. Don Maloney and Robbie Patoryk have scored for the Rangers. Ray Allison for the Flyers. Boston leading Buffalo 7-2. Bruce Crowder has scored for the Bruins. St. Louis and Winnipeg are tied at 1-1. Chicago leading Minnesota 2-1. And Edmonton, a 10-8 loser last night, leads LA 1-0 in the first period.
New York Islanders with the puck. McEwen's pass right wing off the stick of Keller goes deep into the Penguin zone. Dion played it away up the sideboards and Segaron McClellan just unable to hold it, bounced off the heel of the stick, but McClellan keeps working and he throws it in behind. It comes off the corner boards in front. Segaron a shot and Smith made a big save. Segaron again trying to step it in, can't do it. Well, Smith made a big save on Segaron there. Left wing corner. Lane can't get it. Segaron will. Segaron trying to walk out. Shut to Baxter. Let's it go. And it's wide. In behind the net. Nobody there except the Islanders. And they will clear to the near wing for Billy Carroll. McEwen will take the icing call here. Goes behind Chorney to touch it. And they'll come the other way. Well, the Kings walked into Edmonton and beat them 10-8. 10-8.
Set a record for most goals in both teams. 18, breaking the previous mark of 15. That game came in a Stanley Cup final. Montreal beating Chicago 8-7. Billy Smith out wandering around a little bit. Saint Laurent shot goes stop front. Chicago and Minnesota are now 2-2. Lysak and Feimster have scored for Chicago. Steve Payne for the North Stars. And Mark Johnson.
Butch Goring, who has himself a goal here tonight. He'll be at center ice for the Islanders. Hotham, right point, a shot almost got through Smith, but he made the save. Potvin plays it out to Bob Bourne. Couldn't find Goring open, but now it comes to him anyway. Goring on the move, Penguins in. Trying to get through two men. Carlisle finally clears to Rick McLeish. McLeish has the only Penguin goal. Passing to George Ferguson. Right back to Randy Carlisle. Ferguson again with a puck. And he will pass it near side to Greg Hoppe. Back to Carlisle. 8:50 to go, third period. And Carlisle slips it high in the air to the near corner. Hot van to Gilbert. Along the near side. And they'll freeze it. And a face off to the left of Billy Smith. Timeout once again. 7-1 New York, and this is the Penguins Hockey Network. Here at the Coliseum, bringing the fans up to date on what's happening around the league. The goals and the time when they're scored around the NHL. And DeWight here to come in and pick up a lot of information. Another face-off coming up, Islanders territory. Gordie Lane, number 24 of the New York Islanders. Many folks are looking if the Islanders get past the Penguins in this series and the Rangers pass Philadelphia to that crosstown rival series again for the Patrick Division Championship, if it should happen. Andy Van Helleman went down and the Islanders in, slow in getting up. And he has had a bad back of late. That is hurting quite a bit. Here comes Bullard. And unable to get it, Trottier. Trying to get around Carlisle. Trottier still coming in. Carlisle forces him wide, knocks him down. Behind the net, Caller. Out to Tonelli. He walks out. Tonelli, backhand shot. He just missed. Carlisle had Trottier tied up in the corner. Penalty coming up against the Penguins. Shot by Gillies. That's deflected. Trottier goes in against Carlisle. Carlisle has possession. Penalty coming up against the Penguins. And a hooking call will give the Islanders a power play. And it'll be Greg Hotham, Penguin defenseman. Hotham goes off for hooking at 12:06 of the third period. Out of town, Edmonton leading LA 1-0 on a goal by Pat Hughes.
Hotham on the Penguins, two for hooking at 12:06.
So we'll see the Sutter line. Brent Sutter with Dwayne Sutter and Clark Gillies. Denny Buttman and Stefan Pearson. Boutet and Sangeron for the Penguins and killing the penalty. Game three, Saturday night at the arena. The Islanders will have a 2-0 lead in the series. And you must win three to capture it. And Boutet won the draw, pulled it back behind the net. Here's Randy Boyd of the Penguins. Around the near wing, Pearson comes in. He keeps it alive. Price of the Penguins looking to get it out. Kept in by Brent Sutter off his leg. Back to Pearson. Boy, has he had a game. Pearson, right side to Dennis Buttman. Buttman weaving his way through traffic. Over for Gillies. Boyd had him tied up momentarily. Pearson back to Dwayne Sutter, right point. Skates it in. Slap shot, and that hit Boyd. Bounced away to the near wing. Sangeron trying to clear, and he will. The Islanders have to go back to their own end of the rink to pick up the puck. That job is left for Pearson. Soft pass up the left side. Brent Sutter finds brother Dwayne. Cruising behind Gillies. Wristed in behind the net. Price to the left wing side of McLeish, and he does clear. 1:05 left in the penalty for the Penguins' Greg Hotham. Here's Greg Gilbert. That's the only goal of the third period. Carlisle, Baxter slows him down. Bourne has it back to Gilbert, who got back in the play very nicely. In the slot to Putman. He panned on it. You don't see him do that too often. Now Bourne with a puck. Comes in. His shot hits the skates, I think, of Michel Diard. Pearson, can he keep it in? He does. Into the near corner. Goring and Pearson. Goring behind the net. Throws it over to Bourne. Goring's taken down by Baxter. Right point. What a play by Potvin to keep it in. Left side, Pearson's open. Will he shoot it? No, he goes to Goring. Goring has nowhere to go with it. He stops, looks the scene over. Walk it towards the net. Goes back to Pearson. A weak pass broken up by Boutet. Boutet with the puck. We've got a broken stick back in the Penguins' end. Chorney without a stick. And we've got a holding call coming up here against the Islanders. Bourne now takes a whack at Chorney. Bourne right in front of the Penguin bench area. Mark Chorney and Bob Bourne battling one another right in front of that Penguin bench. And with 6:14 to go here in the third period, the score, the Islanders 7, the Penguins 1. This is the Penguins Hockey Network.
Before Mark Chorney and Bob Bourne got the pushing and shoving, Dennis Potvin earned himself 2 minutes in the sin bin. 2 minutes for holding at 13:46 of the third period. Pittsburgh with their third power play chance of the game.
Well, we still have 20 seconds to go on the Hotham penalty. they'll be at equal strength. And Dorothy Nixon, a Butler PA, will be our contestant for the Citizens Watch from Rogers Jewelers in downtown Pittsburgh. If the Penguins do not score, a gift certificate from the folks at Foodland, the Foodland Power Play. Baxter of the pins. They wait for Hotham to come on here in 5 seconds. Gardner rushes up. He'll pass to Kehoe. Can't get into the Islanders' zone. Here's Hotham in the play now. 5 against 4. Carlisle. Hotham goes over to the bench. And we'll have an offside call against the Penguins. 5 minutes and 49 seconds to go in the third period. And the Penguins now with 1:35 to go in the Dennis Potvin penalty. Boutet losing the draw to Goring, but it comes to the Islanders' zone. Johnsonelli here on the penalty killing roll. Baxter in front for Gardner. He took a swipe at it, didn't get anything. Pass comes right to Keogh. Slap shot. Stopped by Smith. Rebound. Keogh can't pick it up. Keogh in the far corner. Turned around by McEwen. The Islanders now trying to kill this penalty. Penguins keep it in. Carlisle to Keogh, left wing corner. Keogh moves out behind the net. Centers it in front, and it's cleared by Langevin at the last second. Baxter in. Put it in. Langevin and Boutet battle one another. Langevin fell down. Keogh trying to throw it out in front for Gardner. Keogh to the right of the net. Comes, gives it to Carlisle. His shot knocked aside by Billy Smith. 55 seconds to go in the penalty. Gardner, left point pass. Right side to Baxter. Penalty coming up here against the Islanders. Penalty coming up against the Islanders. An interference call. The Islanders will be shorthanded by 2 men. We shall take a commercial break right now. The score, New York 7, Pittsburgh 1. This is the Penguins Hockey Network.
He gets 2 minutes for interference at 14:59. Islanders will be short by 2 men for 47 seconds. That's what's left on Dennis Potvin's holding penalty.
In the faceoff, Trottier falls on top of the puck. Penguins have a 2-man advantage, and right now on a Foodland power play, Dorothy Nixon. Gordy Lane's got that big wand up. Waving the stick. Baxter and he have some words. Face off to the left of Billy Smith. Up. Gardner had it coming to the right side, swept out by Trottier, and away it goes. Islanders short-handed by 2 men, 37 seconds to go. The 2-man disadvantage. Baxter, right side to Boutet. Broken up by the Islanders, Bob Bourne. Carlisle wheels it over to Boutet, right back to Carlisle. Islanders ice, right side pass to Boutet, turns around, right point, Lane is after, he gives it to Gardner, he moves in, man in front, Keogh, tried to whack it out of the air, Smith got a piece of it, where is it? Comes right back in front, Smith found it. Oh, here's a lucky charm. Baxter and Bourne now have some words right in front of the net.
Pat Boutet with the puck, around to Gardner, he walks in. Tries to go across, bounces up in the air. Smith bats it up in the air. It's coming down, right down in front of him.
That's what I found, Ma. Bourne and Baxter. Now Gordy Lane and Pat Price have some words. Baxter's over to talk to Gordy Lane. Gillies off, Gillies on. And Helm is warning people, hey, let's move on.
Now Lane's going to get a misconduct. They've wheeled him out. Baxter will be going next.
And Hellman is being very stern and trying to keep the tempers under control here. Price is gone. Draw with one another, and it just leads to a worse situation.
Price gets a 10-minute misconduct.
comes at 15:34.
Number 24,
and Gordy Lane will also get a 10-minute misconduct.
Time of the penalty is 15:34. Price of the Penguins, Lane of the Islanders, 10-minute misconduct at 15:34.
Penguins still in a two-man advantage here on a power play. 12 seconds to go on the penalty to Potvin. A minute 25 to go on Tonelli's minor penalty. The Islanders lead 7-1. Happy to have you aboard on our simulcast tonight. We're a little bit remiss in giving the score at times on the radio side tonight, and our apologies to you for that. 4:26 left in the game. Trottier against Malone. Islanders come up with it. They can't clear. Right point. It is McLeish. Trottier stopped it. And at center ice, he works it back to center. Carlisle to Rick McLeish. Into the left wing corner. And Pearsall has the puck to Trottier. Unable to move the puck out. Here's Malone. Left point. First penalty is over. Potvin is on. McLeish with the puck, takes a shot, and that's stopped by Billy Smith. Malone to the near corner for Bullard. Potvin beats him to it. He'll wrist that puck out so quickly, and it goes to center. Carlisle stopped the play. Trottier comes off, Bourne comes on. The puck into the far corner. Islanders in. Malone goes behind the net. Spins it around, looking for Gatsos. Langevin beats everybody to it, and then shoots it up ice. 30 seconds left in the penalty. Bullard to center ice. Islanders in, a shot by Malone, missed the net, hit the glass behind Bill Smith. Comes off the boards, McLeish knocked down, Bourne will be penalized. The Islanders will be shorthanded by 2 men again. Bobby Bourne, a tripping call.
Islanders penalty number 14, Bob Bourne, 2 minutes tripping.
Bob Bourne gets 2 minutes for tripping 16, at 16:41.
Bourne of the Islanders, 2 for tripping.
This will be Pittsburgh's 16, fifth power play 41. Chance of the night. Pulls down Rick McLeish.
Well, Dorothy, we'll give you 18 seconds here on the Foodland power play, and then Mark Gamberdich, I believe it is, and McConnell, PA, will get an opportunity. The first penalty belongs to you, Dorothy, and the minor penalty to Tonelli, and we'll go into effect on the second one. Two-man advantage for the Penguins. Boutet going to Baxter. Baxter handles the puck. He'll come to center. Throw it up the left wing to Rick Kehoe. 6 seconds on the first penalty. Kehoe's pass comes all the way to the near boards. Boutet of the Penguins. Goes to Gardner. He moves in. His shot, the save, rebound. Boutet scores. It is 7-2.
Boutet scoring a power play goal for the second night in a row.
And it comes with Bourne in the box. The penalty is against him. Dorothy, you'll get a gift certificate from Foodland. And Mark Gamberdich will get Citizens Watch from Rogers Jewelers.
Gardner walks it in, takes the shot. Smith makes the first save. Boutet there for the rebound.
Pittsburgh goal is
7-2.
15, Pat Boutet. The assist number 17, Rick Kehoe, and number 20, Paul Gardner.
Kehoe and Gardner on the assist. Four. And the Islanders now.
From Kehoe and
center, McClellan takes it away from Mike McEwen. Steers it over to the New York zone. Ken Morrow touched behind his own goal. Penguins scoring on a power play. Near side, McEwen just wheels it back to kill some time. 2.5 left in the game. Trap long back to the Islanders. Into the rink. McEwen pulled down by Saint-Laurent. Play will go on. McClellan has the puck. A turning shot. The save made by Smith. Whacks it away to the near corner. McClellan goes after it again. His pass off a blade, and it came to Sutter. Just roll it back to the Penguin line. Randy Boyd. Hawkins pass to Saint-Laurent. Broken up by Keller. Looks for Mary cutting down the slot and just beyond his reach. And here is Hotham. Up ahead for shot. His slap shot. That is why. Bill Smith, Islander goaltender, wants Mary to move it away, and he'll go to Gillies at center. Fire right up into the Penguin zone behind the net with a minute 38 to go. Shorney whacked at by Keller, but he does hit Malone in stride. Malone, Islander blue line, couldn't make a play. The Islanders take the puck right away. Here's Pearson. Step on Pearson. Skating brilliantly at center. Just controlling the play. Goes to Langevin. Back to Pearson. On the left wing to Gilbert. And the young rookie. Oop. Right side pass to Brent Sutter. And we have an offside play.
First final of the night. The Boston Bruins have defeated the Buffalo Sabres 7-3. Behind Barry Peterson's three-goal, four-point performance. Bruins now lead that series 2-0. That series shifts to Buffalo for game number 3 on Saturday night. The New York Rangers now leading Philadelphia 5-2 on a goal by Dave Silk.
We are approaching the one-minute mark left here in the third period. Greg Gilbert, Islanders left winger to Langevin. Over to Pearson. Look out. That one took off. Hit somebody in the crowd.
Quebec has moved ahead of Montreal 3-2 early in the third period. Pierre Aubre scoring for the Nordiques. And Winnipeg leading St. Louis now 2-1. On a goal by Dave Babich.
The Babich brothers are playing against one another.
There's brothers all over the place.
Yeah.
Wait till next year. There's more Sutters coming. Probably two more Trotches.
Any shift hours coming?
No, they're baseball and soccer.
Malone, Penguin center Iceman. Yeah, we'll give him a couple of years. The way they're drafting now, maybe that's all he'll need is a couple of years underage. Here's Carlisle. Shooting the puck into the Islander zone. To the near corner, Morrow takes a bump from Malone. Gillies, unable to get it out. Carlisle shot deflected and went off Smith's glove. He plays it back to the near corner. Carlisle does keep it in off the glove of Gillies. And Clark Gillies of the Islanders to center ice to Dwayne Sutter. Chorney cut him off at the pass. 30 seconds left. We have an offside call. Now Chorney and Dwayne Sutter have some words. Gillies and Pat Graham have a hold of one another. Dwayne Sutter and Randy Carlisle have had a personal thing going here the first two games. Sutter's going to get waved off the ice. Slashing call. He's been wanting a piece of Mark Chorney here in this third period. Now he's coming back to bark some more. Now he's going to go in the penalty box.
Islanders penalty number 12, Dwayne Sutter, 2 minutes slashing. Time of the penalty is 19.
Dwayne Sutter goes off for slashing at 19:31.
31.
And Harry Bittner. Harry, this is your big moment. 29 seconds left in the game and a chance to win a Citizens Watch of Rogers Jewelers.
If you live near Harry, call him. Remind him. Wake him up. Tell him this is
this
it.
This is it. Now 27 seconds left, Harry. And it's 7-2. New York Penguins on a power play. If the Pens don't score, a gift certificate from Foodland. He can rush right out tonight and get some groceries. Here comes Boutette, left side. Keel, Islanders in, 13 seconds to go. Boutette behind the net. Out to McQuaid. Will he let it go? He does. His shot, and I think it hit Smith in the post, too. 5 seconds to go. Right point, Boutette. And his shot is blocked. That is it. Game two is history of this playoff series. The New York Islanders now have taken a 2-0 advantage in the series, and the final score tonight. The New York Islanders 7 and the Pittsburgh Penguins 2, and this is the Penguins Hockey Network.
The Islanders 6.
Live. You're gonna see the